The Conference of Speakers and Presiding Officers of Commonwealth, which has kicked off, marks the beginning of Uganda's busy January as the country hosts three international conferences in a short spell of time. Kampala is undergoing a facelift to ensure a modern, attractive and sustainable smart city befitting for visiting delegates. However, some members of parliament are concerned that a number of Ugandans who expected to make a kill in these conferences have been frustrated by eviction from their workplaces where they're earning a living in the name of creating a smart city.
People who have been displaced have been there for some time. They have been aching a livelihood from there. Now, because of the conference, instead of organizing them to benefit, to ache more of their living from there, they are displaced. Their businesses are destroyed. They are chased away from those areas where they are working. They are gone. So I don't know if you ask that person whether he's a beneficiary of the conference, he will be in positive. He will say, I wish they did not come.
As Kampala prepares to host the 19th Non-Aligned Movement and G77 plus China summits, the government has injected billions of money in the organizations of these events. However, lawmakers want government to prioritize economic gains by organizing trade summits on the sidelines of the main conference in order to recoup money invested.
We seem to be concentrating much on putting the country on the international scene, but it must be accompanied with the deliberate efforts to tap into the opportunities, the potential that comes along with it.
I've seen a conference without a theme. This is the first one I'm seeing for my lifetime. Because what are they going to discuss? You look at all these placards which are here. If you can show the people, which theme are they going to talk about?
Lawmakers also demand for a choreographed strategy for small and medium-scale enterprises to make gainful business out of these conferences if they are to make sense to the public.
Importantly, certainly, the local communities will have to gain. Their gains may not be very visible, but you must equate the food, for instance, these delegates are going to eat. This is food coming from Uganda.
Believe that through these local structures, the community are able to benefit. All, even the neighboring people living there. Because these people are going to tour, others will be touring across, getting to know some of the businesses. They are not only going to attend the conferences, either will tour, they will venture within the country.
But some MPs have a strong belief that hosting these mega conferences will boost Uganda's image on the global scene and also market its tourism attractions to the world.
For us as a country, we ought to take advantage of such. We need to showcase our country. We need to show these visitors what Uganda is worth.
Once you have these conferences, make sure you tap to the maximum into the potential you have as a country.
Legislators are optimistic that such conferences will help Uganda to explain its stand on the anti-homosexuality law that has attracted backlash from the West. They believe government can clear all negative propaganda made by some activists on the global scale in order to change the narrative.
Stand according to what the law says, but that will not stop us from coordinating and cooperating with the international body. The international body must understand the language we speak here. If the language we speak here is much better for the benefit of our people, and then they have to abide by that. It is a part of harmony, yes.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.